boys, which is very cool. Shall we move on to a great Canadian? Not a Canadian, A-N, but a Canadian, E-N. I'm talking about a guy from Finland. He also played for the Montreal Canadiens. He's the captain. He's number 11 at Saku Koivu. I love Saku Koivu for lots of reasons. I am obviously a big hockey fan, judging by the ratings of all the hockey coverage across this country. So are you. But you know why I really love Koivu? I really love him? Face-offs. That's it. The guy is averaging just over 62% in the face-off circle this year, which is amazing. It's amazing in hockey because they're a key part of the game. You can't win the play without the puck. And you start by winning a face-off. And I know, that's not exactly the sexiest reason to admire a player. But in Koivu's case, let me just put it this way. To win a face-off, you got to look down and the ref drops the puck right here, right? Huh? You know why that's amazing for Koivu? Because of this.
Koivu got a stick in the face as he tried to take the shot.
Last year, playoffs against the Hurricanes, game three, first round, Koivu gets hit in the eye with a stick. It went up under his visor. Koivu almost lost an eye. The refs blew it. No penalty. It's incredible. He's got a blind spot. He's got a blind spot here, and he still wins those face-offs. You throw in that with the fact that he survived stomach cancer, and he's a little man playing a big man's game getting knocked around. You love Koivu because he's good and he's tough. It doesn't matter what jersey he's wearing, although that would be enough. So Saturday night, the Leafs and the Habs play at the Air Canada Center in downtown Toronto. After the game, I walked up to him to go 10 questions, the hockey edition. Nice to see you, man.
How are you?
How are things?
See you too. Very good, thank you. After a win like that, you know, things can't be that bad.
No kidding, man. How are you feeling? You're good?
Good, yeah. Everything's good. It's the second game of the season. It's going to take some time to really feel comfortable, but so far it's been good.
People talk about your vision, though, and you didn't seem to suffer any effects out there. I just wondered if you guys were... I wondered if Carbo and Gainey were just putting that out, this vision thing, just to kind of throw the other team off.
Well, at least I have an excuse if I don't see my teammates and my linemates there, but...
Have you used that on practice? I didn't see you.
First couple of weeks, it was like, you know, sorry, guys, I can't see you guys.
The puck goes by, it's out of vision, and then it's back, and everything is...
Yeah, the problem for me is just when it's down on my feet.
Yeah.
After a face-off or with a scrum around the net, I lose the puck.
Well, don't tell people that. That's what they'll
put it there. Everybody's asking. I can't tell you guys that.
Are you ready for the rapid-fire questions?
Sure.
All right, here we go.
Before I'm sweating, though.
You're nervous. You should be. Before you played in the NHL, did you... leave your gear in the bag, or did you dry it out?
Dry them out, always.
Always?
Well, my mom did it when I was younger, and then older days, I had to do it.
Now, I know the way you put your gear on is a special thing. You know, do you have a superstition?
Like, no, I'm not really like that. Maybe when it's younger, a little bit, but when you play 82 games, yeah. You lose that bit. But I put always my right skate first, my right elbow bad, shin bad, that's always in right and then the left, and that's the only thing pretty much. It's just a habit, nothing else.
Skates or pants first?
Pants.
Pants first? Always. Have you ever accidentally gone out there and played without a jock?
No.
You ever, never?
No.
You're smarter than that. Okay, what's the best hockey cliche? Is it 100%, 110%? Is it gut check time? Or is it, one day at a time?
We're a good bunch of guys, and we're going to go out and work hard.
You said that in one?
Oh, yeah. That's...
What do you really mean when you say
really
it?
Really nothing. It's, I like my teammates, and that's about it.
Cool. When a fight breaks out on the ice between a couple of players, is it fun for you to watch it?
Well, I've never been involved with an actual fight, so... it brings a lot of spice to a game, and it's part of the game, but... as long as nobody gets hurt, then I think it's great.
You had a hell of a run in the Olympics, and we know the whole Finn-Swede thing. So the question is, was Don Cherry right? Chicken Swedes?
I agree.
You agree? You have to agree. All right, so whose game is it, Canada or Finland's?
I got to get Canadians. It's a Canadian game.
Is it really?
It is.
When was the last time you cried, man?
Probably when my son was born, late June.
Gretzky or Lemieux?
Gretzky.
Why?
Just... the amount of points, the years that he did consistently, it's just, for me, it's amazing, and I don't know how he did it.
Would you play for free for a year if you know you had a real shot at a Stanley Cup?
If I say yes, guys going to say, like, you're a liar, but I would.
You would, really?
I would.
Who's your hockey hero?
When I was younger, Jari Kurri, no doubt.
Who's going to win the Cup first, the Canucks or the Winnipeg Jets?
The Winnipeg Jets.
Nice. All right, Ottawa Senators, what best describes them? As a team of floaters or a team of chokers?
Wow, you give a tough one. Skill team.
Skill team, which is cool. And finally, the last question is, did you ever know that you're in fact the wind beneath my wings?
I surely do. And you know what? I've heard a lot of things that people are bugging you about this in our office. And hey, you're a proud fan, and we're happy to have you.
There you go. Nice to see you, Saku. Thanks,
good.
Man.
Thanks a lot.
Appreciate it. Oh, Saku Koivu, hell of a player. Nice guy as well. I love talking to hockey players. Long before I worked here at CBC, before I worked at Much Music when I was back in radio, I used to work at a sports radio station in Toronto called the Fan 590. And I started as an op and a producer. I went on to be a reporter of sorts, talked to a lot of different athletes. And as they always say, the hockey players, the nicest ones out there. Speaking of good guys who also happen to be hockey fans, although I believe this.